My tumor is about the size of a hockey puck. I was 28 years old when I was diagnosed. Within 3 days of diagnosis, I had my craniotomy. Common side effect of craniotomy is seizures. I take pills 6 times a day.
Two of these, 1.5 of these,
Carlos first came to us 10 years ago with a low-grade astrocytoma, which we removed surgically. He did beautifully. With the follow-up, though, we saw that gradually the tumor was progressing and coming back.
When we reached 2015, the tumor had reached a point where it was dangerously impacting the ventricles within my brain. And I really was going to be faced within the next year of two options, having another craniotomy, although it wouldn't have been nearly as effective because they would have had to cut out quite a bit of brain tissue. Radiation was the other option, but since my tumor is so large, they would have been radiating so much brain tissue. I could have been left with virtually no short-term memory because that's a common side effect. That's when my neuro-oncologist, Dr. Laterra, brought forth this idea of a clinical trial that he believed in because he believed in the science behind the trial. Did they have some idea that the IDH1 mutation existed and they were looking for it? Or was it just some byproduct of another experiment?
IDH1 mutation and its high association with brain tumors was originally reported in 2009. That was the year your tumor was discovered. And so as we're watching your tumor grow, on pins and needles in some respects, trying to make decisions about when are we going to treat this, how are we going to treat it, then all the science leads to the discovery of drugs that inhibit the function of this mutation.
This was really a key that needed to be chased in the medical community. Using the MRIs and the MRS and the blood work, they would be able to see at least whether or not their drug was getting through to the brain. So I definitely felt as if no matter what, if it didn't help me, they were going to learn from it.
Carlos is a great example of what motivates us, and that is that a new treatment was designed and we were hoping that it would at least stop the progression of the tumor, but instead what we found is it really caused a major benefit and it caused the tumor to shrink away.
When they had their neurological conference, they showed my brain and the change, because my change has been the biggest.
It's really, really exciting. You know, we have a very active experimental brain tumor program here. We test numerous medications. To see this is just really, really satisfying for both scientifically in terms of what this means and how it can be developed further, but also for Carlos.
I've always said to all my doctors
that I'm willing to do whatever they want. It was the idea that they would eventually develop an effective drug that would help people with my condition. Like there was justification with my tumor, like it did something for people.
Malignant brain tumors are a devastating disease. And we have devoted our lives to finding better treatment and giving the best possible treatment to the patients. Over the last 10 years, we've seen the median survival more than double. If we can do that again and again and again, it's our hope that we can turn these terrible tumors into a manageable problem that people can live a normal life with.
Knowing myself, I'm not going to stop living the way I'm living. I don't think about any long-term consequences. There's no evidence that the astrocytoma cells may not still mutate. So now, in this moment, I want to live and not just exist. And for those of you like me, there's a way for each of us to live. Know that your health and differences are an advantage and a challenge that few have faced.